measurement of large distances. This method is called Copernicus method. In this method, we can find the relative distance of planet from sun. Relative distance of planet from the sun. Now you can see in the figure, and also one more point here. This method can be used for interior planets. Okay, what is meant by interior planets? The planets which are closer to the sun than Earth. You can see in this solar system, which are the interior planets? Only Mercury and Venus. The planets which are having orbit smaller than that of Earth is called interior planets. And these planets, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, they are called superior planets. Okay? Those are orbiting, the planets which are orbiting outside the Earth. For superior planets, we have different method. This method is only for this Venus and Mercury. So what is interior planet? Planets which are orbiting closer to the sun, means the radius of orbital is less than that of the Earth. They are called interior planets, like Venus and Mercury. So this method, Copernicus method, relative distance of planet from sun. This method can be used only for interior planets. Now you can see here, suppose sun is here, okay, at the center of the elliptical orbit. So here is sun, this is the planet. And this distance is called the relative distance of the planet from the sun as observed from the Earth. When we observe from the Earth, this distance, we will write it as RPS. Suppose RPS is the relative distance of planet from sun, relative distance between the planet and Earth, RPE. And this distance, we will write distance between Earth and sun, RES. This method, we can measure the relative distance between the sun and planet as observed from the Earth. See, this planet is keep on moving in the orbit. Earth also is moving. So in this method, what we have to do, continuously every day throughout an year, we have to keep on observing sun and the planet. We have to focus on the sun. Suppose you have a telescope. First you focus the telescope on sun, then rotate gradually until you reach at the planet. That time the angle formed here, this angle epsilon, it is called the planet elongation angle. Planet elongation angle. And that is represented by the letter epsilon. Okay. So this epsilon is called planet elongation angle. This value of epsilon will keep on changing every day when we keep on observing the sun and planet and measure the angle between these two positions. Because the planet position, relative position of the planet will be keep on changing, maybe here, maybe here, maybe here. Okay, relative position, Earth also is moving. So it is not moving in a same velocity. The relative position will keep on changing throughout the year. But one day when we measure this epsilon, that will have maximum value. The maximum value of epsilon will be only one day. That day, you can see this triangle will be a right angled triangle. Means the angle here between the RPS and RPE, planet sun distance and planet earth distance, in between that two, this angle become 90 degree. That day, this epsilon will be maximum, and that angle is called planet elongation angle. And this planet elongation angle, it can be also called angular distance of the planet from the sun as observed from the Earth. This is the angular distance. The actual distance of the planet from the sun is RPS. Okay? This RPS is subtending an angle epsilon here at this point on the Earth. So epsilon can be also called angular displacement or angular distance. Angular distance between the sun and planet as observed from the Earth. You got the point?
Yes, sir.
Means the distance RPS is converted into angle here. Distance RPS is converted to angle, epsilon. Okay. So once again, the planet elongation is the angular distance of the planet from the sun as it is observed from the Earth. And this epsilon value will be keep on changing every day when we observe sun and planet and measure the angle by using a telescope. And one day it will become maximum. That day this triangle will be a right angled triangle. On that day we have to do the calculation. Got the point? So for that, first of all, we have to measure the planet elongation angle. For example, in this figure, we can measure the planet elongation angle. What is the planet elongation angle right now? 35 degrees, the planet elongation angle. Now listen here, in this particular day, from the triangle, from this triangle formed by the sun, planet and earth, if I define sine theta, sine of the epsilon, sine of the angle, sine epsilon is equal to what? Sine theta is opposite side by hypotenuse, correct? Equation will be RPS divided by RES. Means the distance between planet and sun divided by distance between earth and sun. RES is the distance between earth and sun. So we need to find RPS. We need to find the relative distance of the planet from the sun. To find the relative distance of the planet from the sun, from this equation, RPS is equal to RPS is equal to RES into sine of the angle, RES into sine of the planet elongation angle. Here RES, that is the distance between the earth and sun, it is the average distance between the earth and sun, and that RES value, the average distance between the earth and sun, it is actually 1.5 into 10 to the power 10 raised to 11, 10 to the power 11 meter is the value of average distance between earth and sun, and this quantity is called one astronomical unit, one AU, one astronomical unit. You know what is one light year? Yeah, the distance traveled by light in 1 year. In calculation, how much it will come? 3 lakhs kilometer is the speed of light in 1 second. 3 lakhs kilometer in 1 second. So, 1 light year will be 3 lakhs into 365 into 24 into 60 into 60. That much kilometer. Okay? Another unit used in astronomy for finding the distance of planets is AU. So remember, AU is the standard unit used for measuring the distance of planet and all. That is astronomical unit. And one AU is the average distance between earth and sun. So in this equation now, finally, we can write down RPS is equal to the distance between the planet and sun, the relative distance between planet and sun as observed from the earth. RPS is equal to RES, we can write what? 1 AU, okay, one astronomical unit into sine of the angle of elongation, sine of epsilon. Okay, listen here. First, we calculated the distance of the planet from the sun, RPS. Now, we can also calculate the distance between planet and earth. Suppose we need to find the distance between the planet and earth, RPE. Then, from the same triangle, same observation, we can define cos theta or cos of the angle of planet's elongation. What is cos epsilon? That is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is RPE and hypotenuse is RES. Means the planet Earth distance, and that is adjacent side by hypotenuse is Earth sun distance. Distance between Earth and sun. We need to find the distance between planet and earth, that is RPE, planet and earth, that will be equal to RES into cos theta, into cos of the planet's elongation. Okay, what is RES? RES means what? We can calculate the distance between the planet and earth, RPE is equal to one astronomical unit, one AU, into cos of the planet's elongation, cos of the angle epsilon. Okay, so this is the second calculation. From the same observation, we can find the distance between earth and planet.